Let's say that we've got the function f of x is equal to 8 times the natural log of x minus x squared, and it's defined over the closed interval between 1 and 4. So it's a closed interval. It also includes 1 and it includes 4. You can view this. This is the domain of our function as we have defined it. So given this information, this function definition, what I would like you to do is come up with the absolute maximum value of f as defined, where f is defined right over here, where f is defined on this closed interval. And I encourage you to pause this video and think about it on your own. So the extreme value theorem tells us, look, if we got some closed interval, and I'm going to speak in generalities here, so let's say that's our x-axis, and let's say we have some function that's defined on a closed interval, we have a couple of different scenarios for what that function might look like on that closed interval. So we might hit a maximum point. We might hit a maximum point at the beginning of the interval, something like that. We might hit an absolute maximum point at the end of the interval. So it might look something like this. So that's at the end of the interval. Or we might hit an absolute maximum point someplace in between. And that could look something like this. It could look like this. And at this maximum point, the slope of the tangent line is 0. So here, the derivative is 0. Or we could have a maximum point someplace in between that looks like this. And if it looks like this, then here, the derivative would be undefined. There's a lot of different tangent lines that you could place, right over there. So what we need to do is let's test the different endpoints. Let's test the function at the beginning. Let's test the function at the end of the interval. And then let's see if there's any points where the derivative is either 0 or the derivative is undefined. And these points where the derivative is either 0 or it's undefined, we've seen them before, we call these, of course, critical numbers. So this would be either case. Actually, if we assume that that's happening at the same number, we would call that a critical number. Critical number. So those are the different candidates. Now you could have a critical number in between that where say the slope is 0, say something like this, but it isn't the maximum or minimum. But what we can do is, if we can find all the critical numbers, we can then test the function evaluated at the critical numbers and the function evaluated at the endpoints, and we can see which of those are the largest. All of those are the possible candidates for where f hits a maximum value. So first we could think about, well, actually, let's find the critical numbers first, since we have to do it. So let's take the derivative of f. F prime of x is going to be equal to the derivative of natural log of x is 1 over x. So it's going to be 8 over x minus 2x. And let's set that equal to 0. So if we focus on this part right over here, we could add 2x to both sides. And we would get 8 over x is equal to 2x. Multiply both sides by x. We get 8 is equal to 2x squared. Divide both sides by 2, you get 4 is equal to x squared. And if we were just purely solving this equation, we would get x is equal to plus or minus 2. Now we're saying that the function is only defined over this interval, so negative 2 isn't part of its domain, so we're only going to focus on x is equal to 2. This right over here is definitely a critical number. Now have we found all of the critical numbers? Well, this is the only number other than negative 2, but the only number in the interval that will make f prime of x equal to 0. What about where it's undefined? Well, f prime of x would be undefined. The only place where it would be undefined is if you stuck a 0 right over here in the denominator, but 0 is not in the interval. So the only critical number in the interval is x equals 2. So now we just have to test f at the different endpoints and at the critical number and see which of those is the highest. So we're going to test f of 1, which is equal to 8 times the natural log of 1 minus 1 squared. We'll test f of 4, which is equal to 8 times the natural log of 4 minus 4 squared, which is of course 16, And we're going to test f of 2. So these are the endpoints, and this is a critical number. 8 times the natural log of 2 minus 2 squared. Now, which of these is going to be the largest? And it might be tempting to get a calculator out, but actually, let's see if we can get a little intuition here. So this is the natural log of 1 is 0. E to the 0 power is equal to 1. So 8 times 0 is 0. So this evaluates to negative 1. Now, let's see, what does this evaluate to? The natural log of 4, e is 2.7, on and on and on. So this number is going to be between 1 and 2. So it's going to be between 1 and 2. And it's actually going to be, well, between 1 and 2, you multiply that times 8, you're going to be between 8 and 16. And then you subtract 16. So that means you're going to be between 0 and negative 8. So okay, so that it's not clear, at least without using a calculator in this very rough way, which of these is large. Both of these are negative numbers, though. Now, what about this? Natural log of 2. Natural log of 2 is going to be some fraction. It's going to be more than a half. It's going to be more than a half. And since it's more than a half, this whole thing is going to be more than 4, which means this whole thing is going to be positive. So this is negative, this is negative, this is positive. And these are only candidates for our maximum value. So I would go with this one. Our maximum value happens when x is equal to 2. And that maximum value is 8 natural log of 2 minus 4. That is the absolute maximum value. Absolute max value over the interval, or I guess we could say over the domain that this function is defined. If we want to verify it with a calculator, we of course could. So we already figured out this one, but let's see. F of 4, 8 natural log of 4 minus 16 is equal to negative 5. So this one is definitely not the maximum value. And then F of 2 is 8 natural log of 2 minus 4, which, as we said, is indeed a positive number. So feel pretty good about what we did.